Hi, I'm Senator Mike Hewitt. Thank you for taking a few minutes to spend with me so I can update you on the things that are happening in Olympia. Last Thursday was cutoff for bills in the House of Origin. So what that means is the bills in the Senate and the bills in the House now have to pass over to the other body to get approval over there. Some good things, some bad things on the chopping block, some still out there that are going to have an effect on all of us if they pass, so we're going to keep a close eye on those and I'll keep you informed as we move down the road. But I still want to focus on the budget today. This Thursday, tomorrow, we're going to be hearing the new revenue forecast. We anticipate that number to probably be around another $500 million shortfall. So now we're going to be talking about the mantra around here is going to be about $9 billion. We are still trying to convince people and show them that this can be done in a much different manner than we are right now. The path we're on with the majority in the legislature is we're going to scare the death out of people. We're going to cry chicken little, the sky is falling. We're going to rush to the polls and ask you to raise new revenue and new taxes. That's not what we should be doing in a recession like today. We've been traveling the state trying to convince people that if we would just stop the freezing in Olympia on June 30th, that this budget deficit is about half of what they're projecting it to be. Now remember, the budget deficit is based on what the revenue projections are versus the spending that's taking place. So this $9 billion budget deficit that everyone's talking about is assuming the legislature makes no changes in the way we deliver services to the people in the state of Washington. This is a prime time for us to take a step back, take a deep breath, and look at the way we do business in the state of Washington. This is not the time to be cutting critical programs. It's not the time to be laying people off. We can get through this if we just stop and look at the way we're doing things and deliver our services differently. There are a lot of efficiencies, both in the way we do government and in some of the policy that we've passed down here in the past few years. The budget has grown 33% in the last 4 years. If we stay on the cycle we're on right now, if we continue the path that we're on right now, 3 years from now, that number will be 50%. That will mean in a 7 or 8 year period, the state budget has grown by 50%. When was the last time that your household budget grew by 50%? In fact, today, people aren't even getting pay raises. 300,000 people out of work in the state of Washington. We have got to take this opportunity, step back, and try and figure out how to do things differently in the state of Washington. So I'm going to keep you more informed as we come along next week. I'll be back to give you an update on where we're at. But again, the bills have passed back and forth between each house, and now we're going to start eliminating things. The House passed over 400 bills. The Senate passed over 300 bills. That's a lot of bills when we're in a recession. Yeah, granted, some of these bills are very small, they don't do much, but there are some of those that have a significant ramification behind them. So I'll keep you updated on those next week. So thanks for taking a few minutes, and I look forward to speaking with you next week.